طب الله اوقاتكم. طب احنا دلوقتي قدام جامع مصعب، ده اكبر جامع في المنطقه، وبعدين في واحد جاب تصريح من الشرطه جاي بقى بيتكلم مع اطفال المسلمين بيقول لهم يعني بدعوهم مباشره للمسيحيه كده. الشرطه واقفه.
And then you go to court and you face a judge. Now, the judge, you may try to plead your case if you want, but here's the thing. Even if you've done good after you've stolen, the judge, and you present that to the judge, say, well, you know, I've done good things, you know, even though I stole, yes, but I've done good things. Well, guess what? If the judge is good, he's just not going to let you go just because you've done good things. Because the job of a judge is to uphold the law. That's, yes, yeah, but God is a judge too. God is the ultimate judge. So what I'm saying to you is that, listen.
Good. Good point.
God is greater than a human judge. So if a human judge is not going to let you go free, much more God is not going to let you go free, and He's greater. So if I'm giving you an analogy, the greater analogy. So that's why I'm saying to you, your good deeds don't erase your bad deeds. It's not going to happen.
What's happening? What's God?
What you need is a sacrifice.
No, it's not true.
You need someone to come into your place.
It's not true. God can make everything. No, it's not true.
In a human courtroom, even though you're guilty, if someone comes and pays your fine, guess what? I know. But listen, do you know what's an analogy? How old are you?
Huh?
How old are you?
Two.
Maybe I should go to somebody else because you're.
والله برافو عليك. شوفوا العيال المسلمين.
العيال
المسلمين بصوا.
Okay.
بيثبتوا هو جاي قدام الجامع بيستهبل يعني.
For those of you who do understand.
بيستهبل وجاي يقول للناس.
Your good deeds will outweigh your bad deeds.
Good job يا شباب والله.
You can go before God and say all your good deeds, while your bad deeds are still there. He's gonna hold you accountable for your bad deeds. You want to talk about God now? We're gonna talk about God now. God is not going to let you go free, and He's not going to let you into heaven.
No,
just because
he can get, He can make you go free because He can do anything you want.
So that is why. So I know what God's going to do because it's written in His word. I have His word on it.
Who told you His word?
Okay, I have God's word, right? So guess what?
Okay.
Homosexuals, if,
listen,
liars,
listen,
thieves,
listen. I have question for you. I have question for you.
What's your question, sir?
If you're,
hold on.
If the God asks you to eat bullshit, you will eat it. You will eat it.
Will he ask me?
Because it's written in your book. It's written in your book. Open Ezekiel. You can read for me.
Actually, you said to eat dung. He said to cook food from dung.
Okay, you can open Ezekiel. You can open.
I know what you're talking about.
Okay, just let them know.
I know what you're talking about.
Let them know.
Yeah, God told the prophet Ezekiel to cook food out of dung. From dung.
Okay, just read it. He tell him. Ask him to eat food.
I know
food.
What it says.
Open your book. Let the Bible speak.
So what's your point? What's your point? Yes.
I ask you.
I already admit it. Yes.
If your God asks you to eat bullshit, you will eat it.
I'll do whatever God tells me to do.
Really?
Because He's God.
Okay. He ordered because you in book God. To eat to eat
if,
bullshit.
If God tells you to sacrifice your son, will you do it?
No.
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 Then you're disobedient to God. You're not like Abraham. You're not like
I'm
Abraham.
Not like Abraham because I'm
not
prophet.
Like Abraham.
I'm not like Abraham. Of course.
You're not like Abraham. You should be like Abraham
okay.
Because
now,
Abraham
Now I have a question.
Abraham feared. I have a question for you now.
You come here to say listen. You come here.
I'm not talking to them.
Small kids.
I'm not talking to them. I'm talking to you now. I'm talking to you. So I got a question for you. How do you enter the kingdom of heaven?
Okay. Sorry?
How do you enter?
If you listen to God's rule.
Yeah.
How do you enter?
By,
I'm asking you. By, I want to hear from them.
By God's mercy, but this is not the
by
question.
God's mercy.
Now you come here to invite these people.
Okay.
To
so
invite.
It says by God's. Listen. I didn't invite them.
I don't challenge my friend. My friend, I don't challenge you.
No. Just saying that.
Jesus said, you know the truth, and the truth make you freedom. And also he
said.
What?
We said what?
You know the truth, and the truth make
and
you
the
free.
Truth will make you free. Yeah.
Yeah. And he always said always ready to give defense about what you believe.
Yeah.
So are you always ready?
1 Peter 3:15.
Are you always ready?
Yeah.
Okay. You can open Song of Solomon. You can open your book. You can open. Anybody can open.
He has my Bible.
It's better. If you can open. Okay. You can open your Bible.
Okay. What's your
I want
question?
You read.
I'm gonna go to Song of Solomon. What is your question?
I want you read your Bible here.
I have to buy.
Okay,
bring.
You can read it for us, please. You can read it.
What chapter and verse you want me to read?
Chapter 7.
Chapter 7.
Yeah.
God's gonna do
step by step. You said this book from God, yeah?
Yes, it is from God.
Okay.
Why has it been changed so many times?
Okay, I'm sorry, but may you listen something over 18. So I don't know if it's suitable for you to hear this or not.
Over 18 to read a book.
Yeah.
That's stupid.
Chapter 7.
Yeah, read it.
What verse?
First one to 7. 1 to 7.
1 to 7?
Yeah.
How beautiful are your feet in sandals?
Yeah.
O prince's daughter?
Yeah.
Yeah. O prince's daughter?
Yeah.
The curves of your thighs are like jewels.
Sorry?
The curves of your thighs are like jewels.
Huh?
The work of the hands of a skillful workman.
Yes.
The navel.
Navel?
Your navel is a rounded goblet. It lacks no blended beverage. Your waist is a heap of wheat set about with lilies. Your two breasts are like two fawns.
Two breasts?
Twins of a gazelle. Your neck is like...